working on the Ethics and Governance of Artificial Intelligence project here at Berkman Klein, and there are a lot of questions as to how exactly incorporating this new technology into different social environments is really going to affect people. And I think one of the most important things is getting people's perspectives who are actually going to be impacted. So I'm looking forward to participating in some early educational initiatives and some discussions that we can post online and blog posts and things to help people feel like they're more familiar with this subject and more comfortable, because it can be really intimidating. Right now, this technology or early versions of machine learning and artificial intelligence applications are being used in institutions ranging from the judicial system to financial institutions, and they're really going to impact everyone. And so I think it's important for people to talk about how they're being implemented and what the consequences of that are for them, and that we should have an open discussion, and that people can't do that if they're unfamiliar with the technology or why it's being employed. And so I think that everyone needs to have at least a basic familiarity with these things, because in 10 years there's not going to be an institution that doesn't use it in some way. I grew up in a pretty low income community that didn't have a lot of access to these technologies initially, and so I was very new to even using a computer when I got into college, and it's something that was hard for me initially, but that I started really getting interested in, partially because I'm a huge sci-fi fan now. And so I think that sci-fi and fiction really opens up your eyes to both the opportunities and the potential costs of using different advanced technologies. And so I wanted to be part of the conversation about how we would actually approach a future where these things were possible, and to make sure that we could use them in a way that would benefit us, and, you know, not the scarier, more dystopian views of what could happen. Software is so scalable that we can offer more resources and more information to so many more people at a lower cost. We're also at a time that we have so much more information than we've ever had in history. So things like machine learning and artificial intelligence can really help to open up the answers that we can get from all of that data, and maybe some very non-intuitive answers that people just have not been able to find themselves. I think the thing that scares me most is that artificial intelligence software is going to be employed in institutions and around populations that don't understand both ends of the things it has to offer, but also its limitations. And so it will just be taken as objective fact, or like a scientific opinion that you can't question, when it's important to realize that this is something that is crafted by humans, that can be fallible, can be employed in different ways and have different outcomes. And so I think my biggest fear is that we won't question it, and that these things will just be able to be deployed without having any kind of public dialogue or pushback if it has negative consequences.